The president there saying, I could not be prouder of the men and women in uniform, saying this is a good day for Americans, that the world is a safer place because of the death of Osama bin Laden, reminding this country that there is nothing we cannot do, again invoking the spirit of unity that we heard him first speak about in the overnight hours in our special report as we first learned the news about 12 hours ago. I want to bring in our chief White House correspondent, Jake Tapper. And Jake, you've learned more about laying Osama bin Laden's body to rest at sea and how that was transported, how that was fulfilled, and what can you tell us about that?
Well, first of all, David, just in the last few seconds, administration officials have told me that the DNA evidence has come back, and there is a 99.9% certainty that the body is Osama bin Laden's, essentially proving that this was Osama bin Laden. Osama bin Laden's corpse was taken by the troops to the aircraft carrier, the USS Carl Vinson. He was buried at sea according to Muslim tradition. There was a Muslim seaman who was there, and they wrapped him and said the prayers according to what is part of the Islamic tradition, the idea being not to inflame the Muslim world in any way. Right now, White House officials are fiercely debating whether or not they should release a photograph of bin Laden's corpse. Those arguing in favor say it needs to be done to rest assure, to rest aside any concerns, any skepticism that this did not happen. But I'm also told by somebody who has seen the photograph, it is a gruesome photograph with bin Laden taking a bullet wound above his left eye. It is a photograph that has brains and blood in it. And so those are the issues being debated right now, David.
But as you point out, a lot of questions, people down at Ground Zero asking me just today, are we going to see an image? But Jake, I also wanted to show you these images from the Defense Department, satellite imagery that actually shows the compound where Osama bin Laden was captured, killed. You can see as we push in on it there, much larger than any of the homes surrounding it. The second image actually shows just how high the walls were, upwards of 12, 18 feet around this compound. What more have you learned about the operation to nab them?
Well, this compound itself is one of the reasons why intelligence officers were so sure that something was going on here. They had traced a courier that had links to bin Laden to this area in 2009. Then in August and September 2010, they found this compound, and it was all the information, all the details you just described. It was tough to get in, a few windows, high walls, extra security, no television, no phones, no internet, that made them very suspicious. The more they looked at this compound, the more they said there is a high value target in this compound, and ultimately they were not sure bin Laden was in the compound until the Navy SEALs stormed the compound on Sunday and delivered the message, yes, it is Osama bin Laden.
Incredible work from those elite American forces. Jake Tapper, I know you've been up all night. We appreciate your continued reporting on this. We are going to return now to your regular programming, and we hope you'll stay with ABCNews.com for the latest all day long. And Jake and I will be joining Diane for a special one-hour edition of World News. Diane Sawyer reporting from Ground Zero. We hope to see you later today. Good day.
This has been a special report from ABC News.